Hi everyone, it's Jeremy here. Hope you're doing all right. Look at me, I'm wearing my nice warm jumper because it's a bit chilly at the moment, isn't it? I wonder how you're all doing. Now, don't forget our theme, our value for this term is, that's right, it's love. And we've heard some stories from the Bible about love over the last few weeks. But I want to tell you something. In the New Testament, in one of the Gospels, Jesus talks about how we must love our enemies. That is a really difficult thing to do. Can you think for a second of somebody you just don't get on with? Don't look at them, whatever you do. Think of somebody you don't get on. Maybe it's somebody even in your own family. Maybe it's a brother or sister. Maybe you're having a hard time with a brother or sister or a cousin or somebody. Most of the time we get on fine with our friends, don't we? We try our best to get on. But sometimes things are difficult, aren't they? But Jesus tells us we've got to love people who are our enemies, people who are different from us, people who we wouldn't normally be friends with. And that is quite a hard thing to do. Now, in the old part of the Bible, there's a wonderful story, which we're going to see in a minute, about a girl who was captured by the Syrians. At that time, the Syrians were Israel's enemy. And their top general was a man called Naaman. And Naaman captured loads of people in battle and took them back to be his slaves. Now, this little girl should have been very angry about Naaman because he had made her a slave and he was the enemy. But instead, she tried to help him because Naaman, you see, was ill. But she knew someone who could make him better. Shall we have a look at the story now? Let's watch the story, shall we? Okay.
Naaman was a great Syrian soldier, but he had a skin disease called leprosy. A young girl from Israel served Naaman's wife. She wanted to help Naaman because he was sick. She told Naaman's wife about a prophet named Elisha who could cure leprosy. Naaman's king sent him to be cured by the prophet, and Naaman took a chariot of horses and left on his journey. Once there, Elisha, a man of God, asked to see Naaman. He told Naaman to wash 7 times in the Jordan River. Naaman was angry because he thought Elisha would wave his hand over him and cure him. He also thought the rivers in his country would be better than the Jordan River, but he decided to do what Elisha said. He dipped 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 times. When he obeyed what he had been told, his leprosy was gone. He was so happy. He said, "Now I know the God of Israel is the only God."
So that was a brilliant story, wasn't it? About how one girl felt sorry for her enemy and helped him. And that caused Naaman to get healed. Brilliant story. So it's been ages since we've done a song together. And I've got my guitar here. So I'd like to teach you a song which is really, really easy. And the chorus goes, show some L-O-V-E, that's love, for your E-N-E-M-I-E-S, that's enemies. So should we try singing it, see how we get on? Okay, all right. Show some L-O-V-E for your E-N-E-M-I-E-S. If you're kind, then you will find your enemies are your friends. Show some L-O-V-E for your E-N-E-M-I-E-S. If you're kind, then you will find your enemies are your friends. Sometimes people need to be forgiven. Sometimes we must all apologize. Words are said, but no one meant to say them. It's up to you to try and put it right. Think of someone you don't get along with. You think of someone you don't get along with. Have a good think. Today's the day to turn it on its head. Maybe it will start by saying sorry. Pray that God will make you friends instead. Show some L-O-V-E, E-N-E-M-I-E-S. If you're kind, then you will find your enemies are your friends. If you sing it, show some L. For your
L-E-M-I-E-S.
If you're kind, then you will find your enemies are your friends. One more time. Show some L-O-V-E for your E-N-E-M-I-E-S. And if you're kind, then you will find your enemies are your friends. Thank you. It's lovely to be able to sing with you guys, even though you're over there and I'm over here in my study at home. It's nice to join in together. And it's great being with you today. Before we go, I'm just going to say a little prayer. Is that all right? So let's close our eyes, put our hands together. Dear Lord, help us to be a good friend to people, even people we don't get on with. Help us to help them, even if they're mean to us. Help us to be kind to them, just like Jesus said we should. Please be with all our school, all our teachers, all our families. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I hope to see you soon. You take care and don't forget to love your enemies. Bye.